Well, it's conclusion time. Final thoughts, final opinions, final conclusions. These two guns, obviously I own both of them. I've chose to own both of them for specific reasons. I fired both of them. What do I think? To tell you the truth, I like the Smith & Wesson M&P9 a little bit more. And for a couple reasons. Number one, I love the ergonomic nature of the grip more than I do the Springfield. It feels, and I mentioned this before, it just feels so much better in the hand. It fills the hand more. It just feels more ergonomic. And I really like that. And for really that's one of the main reasons why I like this gun more. It's more comfortable to shoot. I think I'm a little bit more accurate with it also. I think a lot of that comes with the fact that I've just simply owned this gun longer. So I've put more rounds through it, and I'm a little bit more familiar with it than I am with the Springfield. So, you know, I've put probably, I don't know, 1,200 rounds maybe through this gun, as opposed to probably 300 through that one, the Springfield. So, a little bit more experience with the Smith & Wesson from the standpoint of being able to fire it. I like the port window on top. I like to physically be able to see into the chamber. I'm not relying on some mechanism to tell me what's going on. You know, I can look in there and see if it's loaded. I like the magazine release better. I think it's a little bit more ergonomic, and it's a nicer feel. It doesn't require as much downward pressure with the thumb. And I like the overall size. Not that I have anything against the longer barrel of the Springfield, and obviously the XDM is available in a shorter size than the 3.8, but I kind of like this 4.25-inch barrel. It just does really well for me. I like the scalloping on here. It really digs in. I like the sights. It's an extremely accurate gun. The only beef I have with this gun is this slide stop. If I do this, you kind of have to mean to kick that slide stop with your thumb. Okay, not that it's a major problem for me, but watch this. I can kind of go over this with my thumb, and you can hear it. I'm catching it, but I'm not actuating it. That time I caught it. With the Springfield, every time, you're gonna catch it. It's a much bigger lever, and it's a little easier to push. In fact, I can cock this over and I can just swipe my thumb down just like this. Watch. Boom. Got it. Every time. Never fails. Not quite so with the Smith & Wesson. The lever is much closer in to the barrel. It doesn't stick out as much. It's a little harder to catch with the thumb, and it's got a little bit more force to kind of manipulate it. The good thing there is that it is also on the other side of the gun. So if you're, you know, left-handed shooter, you have that option there. It's one of the perplexing things about the Springfield, why they do the ambidextrous magazine release button, but then they don't put a slide stop lever on the other side of the gun. I don't know. Maybe that's a big thing for left-handed people. Maybe it's not. I don't know. I'm not left-handed. But kind of odd. So overall, like that gun a little bit more. I will say this about the Smith & Wesson, though, or excuse me, the Springfield. I do like the higher magazine capacity. I do like the fact that this actually does have a safety as opposed to the M&P, which does not. I really like this forward scalloping here to be able to do that with the gun, be able to grip that a little bit better. I really like that. It does have the magazine, the chamber, around in the chamber indicator, which is nice. I like to have something like that. It, you know, this isn't too bad. It's just a little lever that pops up. I mean, I kind of like being able to look in there, like with the Smith & Wesson, but hey, it's something. this little indicator on the back to tell me that the gun is cocked, that's a nice little feature. Personally, I don't really see the need for it. I don't really get anything from it one way or the other. Yeah, the gun's cocked right now. Yay, you know, cool, thanks. Thanks for that info. I don't really see the point in it myself. None of my other guns I've ever owned have ever done that, and I haven't accidentally shot anybody yet. So, you know, I don't really think that that's too big of a deal. The replaceable backstrap on this gun, I don't like the ergonomics quite as much with this gun. I like the fact that you can change that out, but, you know, I really wish it was, more ergonomically designed, you know, had some form to it like the Smith & Wesson does. It does not. I also wish this was easier to switch out. There's a roll pin here that you have to put a punch in with a hammer and knock it out in order to change it out. Not quite as easy to change on the fly. It's hard plastic instead of more of this rubberized polymer. So, you know, not quite as comfortable. Grip is a little slicker, especially when you get some sweat on your hands. So, you know, a few aspects of the Springfield that I don't like quite as much. Don't like that release lever. It's not quite as easy to push as the Smith & Wesson. But overall, I really do like the gun. I'm glad I own both. I had a really tough time deciding between which of these two guns to purchase, and so I eventually decided just to get both. I will demonstrate this aspect of it, though. The one thing I haven't done is this tool in the back. I don't take this tool out very much because it's a little bit of a pain in the butt, but you can pull that out. You can use this to switch that sear deactivation lever down for breakdown if you're out in the field or something like that. And that also releases the grip so that you can change your grips out. You can change them out pretty easy that way. You can carry extra ones with you. If you bought some custom ones on the aftermarket, and you maybe bought a few different ones, different kind of degrees of texture and different sizes, the ones that come with it, or if you bought some other aftermarket ones, you know, those are real easy to switch out on the Smith & Wesson, which is kind of a cool thing. Again, here on the Springfield, you got to have a punch and a hammer and a few minutes of your time. So not quite as nice and easy to switch out. Also, not nearly as ergonomic. So in all, I like both of these guns quite a bit. They both shoot really well. I like the look of this gun better. I love that bi-tone look, the scalloping. It just looks real aggressive and cool. Definitely a cool looking gun. Here, I like the feel, the ergonomic nature of the grip. I like the fact that you can replace those back straps a lot easier. You know, two really great guns. I hope some of my opinions have helped. Great shooters from a shooting aspect of it. You won't be unhappy with either gun. Both of them are great shooters, very accurate. So I hope to do some more videos with these two guns as I own them more. I have yet to really pick a definitive gun that I like better, but I do lean towards the Smith & Wesson as my preferred gun in these two. Hey, you know, a couple months down the road or whatnot, that might change. So it'll be interesting to see how the relationship with these two guns change. Thanks for watching.